Hi, I'm Dr. Pratice Berry, and I want to tell you a story. Every morning, I say my prayers and go through my exercises and breathing treatments and breathing exercises and my routine, and I pray for a story that is going to touch somebody and help inform them. And sometimes the stories that come up shock me. This morning, I was reminded of a story. And I thought, where did this come from? I must have been around 13. I was attending the Mother Church of God in Christ, and there was a woman there, Sister Evangelist Lucille Treadway. She could testify. She was saved, sanctified, filled with the Holy Ghost, speaking in tongues as the Spirit gave utterance. And every time Sister Evangelist Lucille Treadway, you had to say the whole thing, paid her tithes, she'd come shouting up to the tithing box, hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, one day she asked me to help her with her cleaning jobs at the bank. I already had cleaning jobs in houses on Saturdays and mornings before the school, so cleaning is what I did, and I did it well. And I was like, yes. We had been cleaning that bank for some time when one night, something happened that was just otherworldly. We were doing our job upstairs, and it was my job to do the mopping along with several other jobs. Now that I think about it, most of those jobs. And I was going down to the basement to fill the metal bucket. There was one of those big, heavy mops. It wasn't, you know, the modern mops that we have now. It was the rope mop. And I was taking it downstairs to fill that mop. That bucket with water. And I suddenly was blinded by a bright, bright light. And I heard the words, stop or I'll shoot. Time stood still for me in that moment. I can still feel those wooden steps under my feet. I can still feel the handle of that bucket in my hand while clasping the mop at the same time. I knew that that mop and bucket might have looked like a rifle, but I also knew that if I dropped that bucket, it would make that loud clanging sound that metal buckets make. So somehow I stammered, I'm the cleaning girl. Time stood still again. That police officer found the light switch and turned it on. And he said, oh, you should have said something. In my mind, I was thinking, nobody told us you would be here. No one had said that they were doing a stakeout because there had been a break-in. They knew that the cleaning people came every day, but nobody bothered to tell us. Every day, tellers and folks would leave money out as a test to see if we would take it. But this test was beyond the pale, the bucket of a 13-year-old girl who was just trying to help her family. We all have these stories in us that we haven't processed. We haven't processed in the light of day. And a story told out loud, a painful story out loud, sets somebody free, usually the listener, always the teller. Free to know that in an instant, my life could have been gone. Free to know that in an instant, that city would have been in another uproar. I'm the cleaning girl. Sometimes these stories don't sit well with folks because they can't find themselves in the center of it. They can't say, that happened to me too. But that's not the point of story. The point of story is listening. Listening to the connection of life. And maybe the connection is not that happened to me too. Maybe the connection is, I see you, I hear you, Together, we work for a better day. All stories connect, but you will not be in the center of anybody else's story. But you can have them in your heart as I hold you in mine. I love you.